and the little birds, the little bitty birds. Front board, you make the waffles. Everybody's gonna get you to the front board. You don't start off there. You start off with fries. First of all, you start off cleaning. That's a good Then you get to the fries. Uh-oh, you're inside the dinner. Then you go from the fries over here to make a sandwich. A little junior burger. But you know you have made it when you get on front board. But in order to get to the front board, they have to watch you make a waffle. Make sure you don't put too much lettuce, too many, and they have to make it. And if you did not get to front board until you went through and proved that you were trained to go from front board. So I got some folks right now still working, yeah, still on backboard, and 20 years later. Yeah, at some point, they watched us to make sure you got promoted after I knew you could handle what's about to come your way. I know right now, that's what God's saying, and I got some promotion for you already, but I got to train you right now, because when you get to a higher level, I got you to know that I'm the one that raised you. You don't do it yourself. God will bring you into it. I'm the one that raised you. So God says, I just got you on the backboard now for training. You're not supposed to stay there all the time. You're not going to be making fish sandwiches all your life. I got you here getting you ready for some waffles. So some amazing blessings, some amazing overflow. And at some point, but there's some training that has to go on for us to recognize that we're restored. But here's not that favorite one of all right here for the O. Here's the O right here for restored. O is right here, one made as one ought to be. Mm-hmm. Glory to God. One made as one ought to be. In other words, when we are restored, we are not just restored to where we were if where we were is not where we should have been. If I'm supposed to end up being here and I only function right here, then at this point, my restoration doesn't take me here. It takes me where I should have been all along. There's some believers right here who don't know you got some authority. There's some believers who don't know you got some dominion. There's some believers who don't know you're righteous. And so as a result of this, we've been operating down here and not living an extraordinary life. And God says, now when I restore you, I'm going to take you to where I created you to be. I'm going to raise where you got. I know the folk around you said you couldn't do it. I know they said you would not be healed. I know they said it would not work out. But when I restore you, I'm about to take you higher from where I created you to be. I don't care where you were. Yes. I'm going to take you when I restore you to where I made you to be. Yes. Too many believers keep functioning beneath our potential. We're in the middle of EOGs right now. We got some kids right now in the midst of exams, not living up their potential. Go repeating grades over and over. Got all the potential in the world, but trying to hang around folks. And I don't understand why, if they're going to emulate somebody, why emulate somebody who doesn't comb their hair? Why emulate somebody who doesn't know how to put a belt on and pull up their pants? Why follow the trend of prisoners with pants down and then walk around with pants? And you don't emulate somebody who's already made it and already doing well in life. And so God is saying at this point, you may not know where I created you to be. But when I restore you, I'm not going to take you where you thought you should be. Yes. I'm going to take you higher than you ever thought you could go in life. I'm going to take you higher than you ever thought you could go in life. I'm going to take you higher because I'm a God of restoration. And too often, we've been functioning, supposed to function here, been functioning here, go down here, just happen to be restored. That is not restoration. Restoration says now that God says, now when I thought about you from the beginning of time, I had an anointing on your life. And when you stop trusting me and relying on me and stop relying on the lottery ticket and stop relying on loans and stop relying on payday loans, when you stop relying on credit cards that are maxed out, oh glory. So I start relying on me. I'm going to take you to where I created and destined you to be. Not where you've been, but where you ought to be. That's restoration. Restoration said it's going to finally function to the point we should be in the R and E again, simply repair and equip. So restoration. So that's, now you may not be able to read this, but I just want to listen to this if you would. If you can read it, please read it with me. But this is just such, this I will provide, offer lays a great foundation for our teaching for this month. God will never leave you empty. God will replace everything you lost. If he asks you to put down something down, it's because he wants you to pick up something greater. Boy, that's worth the price of admission right there. So that God It said that this pump will never leave you empty. He will replace everything that you lost. You can also add that was stolen. If he asks you to put down something, he's not trying to take something from you. He's trying to give something to you. And so as a result, it's because he wants you to pick up. You're going to put this down to pick up something greater. I'm going to put down a burden to pick up a blessing. I'm going to put down a trial to pick up a triumph. I'm going to put down my hurt to pick up my healing. If he puts something down, it's always to pick up something. That's what restoration is all about. So let me give you, we got spiritual principles. I got to give you this first one. Spiritual principle number one. Here's our spiritual principle number one. We're going to talk about this divine restoration. I'm not talking about restoring from the world's perspective. Everything we're talking about this month is from divine restoration. So here's the first spiritual point number one right here. Rest in God's divine restoration. Rest in it. Some of us are worried about something we shouldn't be worrying about, because God's got it. Some of us are worked up over something we shouldn't be worked up over, because God's already worked it out. We keep sometimes as believers living like we don't have the promises from the Word. That God has already made. Now God, it says over in Numbers chapter 20 that God is not a man that he should lie.
That's right.
So if he has made a promise, it's already come to pass. I just got to be positioned to receive what's already been passed. So many of us are working too hard at work instead of at this point resting in divine restoration. Are you with me on that? It's time to rest in God's restoration. Time to rest in God's divine restoration. What are we talking about here? Because this divine restoration is going to lead to total recovery. Whatever was broken, whatever was down, it's time to have some whole and some complete Christians in the name of the Lord who know we are complete in Him, because God has already, not going to, He is already. He is not physically, He's already. He may not, He's already restored us to have total and complete recovery. Now, so the idea we talk about this rest in, what is spiritual rest? What is it? First of all, let me give this acronym here. It's simply, rest is simply releasing every stressful trial. Releasing every stressful trial. At some point, we just got to release it. Now, let's be clear about what we're saying here. Anybody here ever had a stressful trial? Mm-hmm. Amen. Now, here's the point. Most of the time, if we're real honest with each other, we have held on to that spiritual trial way too long. Mm-hmm. We've held on to it, we've nursed it, we've rehearsed it, we've cursed it instead of reversed it. We've gone in here and looked at spiritual trial and this distressful trial, and we are talking about it and getting people on our side, and don't let that be just a disagreement in a relationship. We're going to get somebody on our side. At some point, we've held on to this stressful trial. But we just got to talking about earlier, what did it say up here? We just got to saying here initially that at this point, God will never leave you empty. He's going to replace everything you lost. If he asks you to put down something, at least that trial, the stressful trial, to pick up supernatural triumph. That walking around here with this, if this pen, I need something big. If I get healed, this is, oh, praise God, this is good right here. Here we go. Take two. All right, put it, okay. Imagine that this is a stressful trial. It's huge. Messed us up. Well, the point is, I can't get anything else because this thing is occupying my space. And if I'm trying to get something else, I can't get it because I'm balancing trying to hold on to this. And now I'm trying to hold. And God said, now I need you to put this down. So you can receive. Oh, boy, I'm about to preach it. So you can receive what I already have for you. But so we so busy trying to hold on to our trial. Girl, give me your trial. Girl, you know I got it. You got trial. Hold on to everybody's trial. And God said, no, I need you. You're not big enough. I didn't create you to hold on. I need you to release this. To receive what I have for you. I want you to let this go. Because your hands have to be clean. And your hands have to be open. To receive some wonderful gifts I have for you. I got some restoration for you. I got some breakthrough for you. I got some favor for you. I got something for you, but your hands are occupied with stuff you never supposed to have. We got this huge, enormous spiritual trial over here, it's this stressful trial in our lives, and cannot get supernatural triumph because we keep holding on to the stressful trial. Keep holding on to it. Keep holding on to it. It gets bigger and bigger. And God, and we got all these scriptures. Psalm 55:22. Cast your cares upon the Lord, because he'll sustain you. Over here in 1 Peter 5:7. Cast your cares upon the Lord, and because he cares for you. And we keep holding on. When I got to release in order to embrace. I got to release stuff from the world to embrace what God has promised in the Word. I got embracing what God does for you is the best thing you can do for him. So in other words, he said, I need you to release stuff I didn't give to you. I didn't give you fear, let it go. I didn't give you worry, let it go. I didn't give you doubt, let it go. I didn't give you being intimidated, let it go. I didn't tell you to be hesitant, let that go. So you can now embrace what I have for you here. So this idea, first of all, we have here about this idea of, so now this, the releasing every stressful trial. That is, first of all, what it is. The question is, here's the point. How do you receive spiritual rest now? I'm not talking about taking a nap in class. How do you receive spiritual rest? How do we receive spiritual rest? It comes right here from the book of Hebrews right here. Write down Hebrews 5:10, please. It says, we cease from our own work as God did. That when God said, it is finished, and this is probably something that we really thought about this long term. In Sunday school when we were growing up, says God rested on the seventh day. And I remember being in like a lower grade, and we had, and sometimes they give you little cartoon things to draw in, and they had this man with this long beard with some sandals on, kicked back on a lounge chair. And for years, I thought that's what it meant God did by resting. And so often we think that's what he did. He worked 7 days and just wore him out. Made woman just worn out. No. He rested because it was what? Completed. An attorney rests her case when she's completed. She didn't ask you to pull out a cot to take a nap. It's rested. So here's the point. In order then, right here for this one, to receive spiritual rest, we cease from our own work as God. What does that mean? That means here's a problem in life. Instead of trying to figure it out in my own work, I ask God for direction about how to handle it. God, what do you want me to do? How do you want me to handle it? And at some point, we've gone through here trying to figure this thing out. Please write down Proverbs 3:5-6. You know that very well. It says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. What does that mean at that point? It means at this point that I'm not ceasing from my own work, says, I dare not worry because God has worked it out. I dare not doubt because I know it's already worked out for my good. I dare not go up here and get all upset and agitated and frustrated because right now I know what the end already is. God said at this point, he has promised me restoration. I don't know when it's going to come. I don't know how it's going to come, but I know I'm already restored in the name of the Lord. And I'm going to step right down. I'm going to praise him like I have it. I'm going to believe like I got it. I'm going to trust like I got it. I'm going to have it like I have it. I'm going to believe like I have it. I've already been restored. So the process may be a while, but I know the end result.
Yes.
May take a while. Even come this morning. Some folk got here early. Some folk had to go around and pray. They busy got here. Now, the deal was, the destination is, at that point, restoration. The idea is that we don't know when we're going to see the manifestation of it, but God has already promised we'll have it. We cease from our own works. How do we receive it? But I cease from our own works. Now, watch this one. Get this one now. This is all part of, we're going to rest in God's divine restoration. Get this part. I love this part here. What keeps us from receiving rest? I'm talking about spiritual rest now. This is the question. Think about this now. If rest is releasing every stressful trial, and at this point we said from before, how do I receive it? It's by ceasing from my own work as God did. What keeps us from receiving spiritual rest. What do you think? Open up, everybody.